Before we start the video, let me give you a brief introduction about myself. I'm Chandresh Mahajan, who is founder and chief educator at Exergic, which is India's most trusted and comprehensive institute for online GATE preparation. I got an All India rank 37 from GATE Mechanical Engineering, and I am an ex-Indian Oil officer, having 6+ years of teaching experience as of now. To know more about our GATE courses, you can contact us on these details. Also, you can download Exergic GATE preparation app from Google Play Store. The link is available in the description of video.
When I was telling you about the conclusions of Reynolds analysis, of Reynolds experiment, I told you that the flow depended upon four things: density, the viscosity, and the characteristic dimension. There was a term which was called as characteristic dimension. I told you that the characteristic dimension was equal to the diameter of the pipe for that experiment, right? The Reynolds number, the dimensionless number formed by all those important parameters like density, velocity, viscosity, and characteristic dimension was this, right? Rho V L by mu. I have written L here, which is characteristic dimension, but that was equal to D for the pipe, because the Reynolds experiment was conducted for the pipe. But it does not necessarily have to be the diameter of the pipe only. It will depend upon what type of conduit, what type of, you know, system we have, in which flow is occurring, whether it's a pipe or whether the flow is occurring over a plate or it is occurring over a cylinder. So it depends upon what type of system do we have, on which or through which the flow is happening. Okay, so it's not a fixed thing. What exactly does it tell? It tells that, means it's that dimension of the pipe or it's that dimension of the system which will affect the type of flow. For example, if we have a pipe, there is a particular type of flow, let's say turbulent flow occurring inside that pipe. Okay, and if we increase the length of that pipe, the flow will still be turbulent. It will not get converted into laminar, right? Now consider about the diameter. Same flow is there. It's a turbulent flow. Now what we did is we are decreasing the diameter. We will start decreasing the diameter. So till what extent can we theoretically decrease it? I'm not talking about practical decrease. Theoretically, how much lesser or how much smaller diameter can you have? You have to have the diameter so that at least one single particle can enter. Consider a pipe that has become nothing right now. If only a single particle can enter into that, you can practically, it's not possible, but theoretically, hypothetically, that has the space just to enter a single fluid particle. And it's so small. So if the flow was turbulent earlier, it will get converted to laminar now, right? Because the particle entering cannot move in any random direction. The space is only for the linear movement of a single particle, right? So diameter is affecting the flow. It's not true for length, but it is true for diameter. So turbulent flow got converted to laminar flow by decreasing the diameter, right? So for the pipe, its length is not affecting the flow. Its diameter can affect the flow. So the characteristic length or characteristic dimension which can affect the flow or which can affect the Reynolds number is the diameter and not the length for the pipe, right? So it depends upon what type of system do we have. So on the basis of flow, we have two types of flow. External flow means on the basis of how flow is occurring with the system. It is either external flow or it is internal flow. External flow is that flow which occurs, you know, over a particular surface. Like if we have a plate, a flat plate like this, and some fluid is flowing over it. So it's an external flow. We have a cylinder. Okay. And flow is occurring over it. So it's an external flow. But if we have a pipe of circular cross section and fluid is flowing into this, then it's an internal flow. Right? I'm sure you got the difference. For external flows, the characteristic dimension or the characteristic length is equal to dimension of the surface or dimension of that solid system which is along the flow. For example, in this case, this is the length of the plate, let's say. I'm not talking about the width, I'm talking about the length. So the length of this system is the dimension, is the mean dimension along the direction of flow. So that will be equal to its characteristic length. So for this case, L is equal to, this L is equal to, let's write it as L dash. So L dash, characteristic length is equal to L dash. For this case, the major dimension along the direction of flow is this, the diameter, right? Even from the top, it has to travel a distance, right? So the projection of that distance is equal to the diameter of this particular cylinder. So for this case, characteristic dimension or characteristic length is equal to its diameter. So for any external flow, you just have to see that the flow is happening over a surface. So the dimension along the flow of that surface will be the characteristic length or characteristic dimension for an odd number. Okay. What about internal flow? For internal flow, the characteristic length or dimension is given by 4 cross-sectional area divided by perimeter. This is the expression from which you can calculate the characteristic dimension. 4 multiplied by cross-sectional area divided by perimeter. Now, if the pipe is circular, then cross-sectional area is equal to pi by 4 d square, perimeter is equal to pi d. Pi, pi cancel, 4, 4 cancel, this cancel, ultimately we will have diameter. So its diameter will be the characteristic dimension. If it is square, if the pipe is square in cross-sectional area, then also you can calculate by the same way. L is equal to 4 times of area is side square. Side is, let's say, A. Perimeter is 4A. So upon cancelling, you will get A, the side. That is equal to characteristic dimension for the flow through square cross-section pipe. Okay. So whenever you have internal flow, use this expression. This is also called as hydraulic diameter. Hydraulic diameter or effective diameter. Or effective diameter. Okay. So for internal flow, apply that. For external flow, keep this concept in mind. So this is not something which is clearly mentioned in most of the sources. They will just tell you that for this case, this is the characteristic length. For that case, that is the characteristic length. But if you have this clear distinction in your mind, then you won't face any problem. But keep in mind that this explanation of characteristic length, which I'm giving you, is for Reynolds number. Okay.